This video introduces the Stair Edit Mode, which is used to edit the geometry of individual stair sub-elements created by the ARCHICAD Stair Tool. As shown in other clips, ARCHICAD stair elements are composed of hierarchical sub-elements. The Stair Tool offers an edit mode similar to the edit mode available for the Curtain Wall Tool. To activate it, select the stair you want to edit and click the Edit button appearing near the lower right area of the stair. The Stair Toolbox appears in the upper left corner of the viewpoint. Several improvements have been added to all the tools that use the Edit Mode, including the Stair and Railing tools, as well as the Curtain Wall tool. The first of these improvements is that the Edit Mode is now available not only in 3D, but in the floor plan, section, elevation, and interior elevation viewpoints as well. Therefore, you can begin editing the stair in one viewpoint and then switch to other viewpoints as needed without having to exit and re-enter the edit mode. The second improvement is that the undo queue is now continuous inside and outside the edit mode. Previously, if you made multiple modifications within the edit mode, these modifications were stored as a single step in the undo queue. As a result, all modification steps performed in a single edit mode session could only be undone collectively in one step. Starting from ARCHICAD 21, every single modification within the edit mode is stored as a separate step in the undo queue. This means that modifications can be undone individually, one at a time. The third improvement is that commands and options on the stair toolbox depend on the active viewpoint. The toolbox includes only those options and commands which are valid and relevant in that particular viewpoint. In the floor plan viewpoint, the top part of the stair toolbox contains two options. Selecting the schematic radio button lets you edit the sub-elements of the stair's 3D model, while selecting the symbol radio button lets you edit the sub-elements of the stair's floor plan symbol. When the schematic radio button is active, you can edit the 3D sub-elements of the stair. You can select and edit the stair baseline and stair boundary in the same manner as you would without starting the edit mode. This type of editing is explained in the Editing the Stair Baseline and Boundaries clip in this playlist. Treads and risers can also be selected and edited individually, or several of these can be edited together in a single step. When you hover your cursor over a tread, you can click to select it. Or if you continue to hover, three buttons will promptly appear below the cursor. Clicking the left button will select the tread as well as all the lower treads of the flight. Clicking the middle button will select all the treads of the flight. Clicking the right button will select the tread and all higher treads of the flight, as indicated by the pre-selection highlight. You can also use the Shift key to select individual non-adjacent treads. As far as this selection logic is concerned, winders are considered a part of flights, so two flights connected by a winder is considered by this logic to be a single flight, and the treads will be selected accordingly by these three buttons. Selection works in the same way as when selecting risers. The left button selects the riser and all the lower risers of the flight. The middle button selects all the risers of the flight, while the right button selects the riser and all higher risers of the flight, as indicated by the pre-selection highlight. You can also use the Shift key to select individual non-adjacent risers. When a tread is selected, you can click any of its nodes or segments to begin modifying its geometry with the polygon editing pet palette commands. When a tread's geometry is modified from its default shape, the pet palette will also contain the reset tread geometry command. This will revert the tread's geometry to its default shape. Additionally, you can activate the Custom Tread Polygon Settings dialog from the Pet Palette of Tread Segments. The upper part of the dialog lets you set the tread polygon segment as front, back, left, or right. This value is automatically set to the correct value for each tread segment by default, but you may need to change it if you have modified the tread polygon significantly. In the same manner, you can show segments or hide segments by activating the corresponding radio button. Changes may be applied to only the clicked segment or all segments. The result of hiding segments will be visible on the stair after exiting the edit mode. When a riser is selected, you may click either of its endpoints to drag it to a new position. You can also click the riser segment and insert new nodes or curve its edge using the available Pet Palette commands. When the riser contains a curved segment, you can also use the Insert Node to Arc command to insert a new node at the clicked arc point without converting the arc to a straight segment. Also, when the riser is modified from its default geometry, you can use the Reset Riser Polyline command to revert back to its default. You can modify the structure's geometry by modifying the baseline's polygon or by modifying the boundary's polygon. These polygons can also be selected and modified while in the edit mode in the floor plan viewpoint. The structure of the stair is regenerated based on the changes made to the baseline or boundary. When any tread or riser of the stair is modified, the Pet Palette of the stair baseline and stair boundary will contain the Reset All Sub-Element Geometry command. If you activate this command, all the modified treads and risers will revert to their default geometry based on the shape of the stair boundary. This command is useful when many treads or risers have been modified, and the process of returning them to their default geometry one by one would be much too time-consuming.